There are four cells in the osseous tissue that I want you to be aware of. The first are going to be osteogenic cells, and these are examples of stem cells. These are going to be found in higher densities associated with the outer surfaces of bone and within that medullary cavity as well. And these are going to differentiate into osteoblasts. So there's that term again, the blast. So we know that this is going to be important in terms of that extracellular matrix. And that's exactly what we're going to have the differentiation into these osteoblasts. So these are what are actually building the bone. So building that extracellular matrix that will eventually ossify or calcify and create the hard bone that we're familiar with. So you're going to have these also in higher densities associated with that outer edge of the bone, as well as within that medullary cavity. Now, what happens with those osteoblasts? They're going to secrete the extracellular matrix. They're going to keep surrounding itself with extracellular matrix or secretion, and eventually it'll kind of lock itself in. And then you're going to have what's the creation of what's referred to as an osteocyte. And these are the main cells or the mature bone cells. So once there's no more secretion of extracellular matrix, that's when you're going to have the development of these osteocytes. Now, it's important to note that these cells are not dead, so not what we had in terms of the epidermis with those corneocytes. These cells are still doing something. They're still communicating with other osteocytes in order to upkeep the daily metabolism of the bone tissue. And one thing I want you to note with this really nice illustration are all these processes of the osteocytes. And what's going to happen is that these processes are going to communicate with processes of another osteocyte. So being able to actually communicate between cells. And lastly, the fourth cell I want you to know are the osteoclast. And anytime you have this suffix of clast, that's going to mean resorption or bone or some type of breakdown. And in this case, it's going to be the breakdown of bone tissue. Now, this seems like a bad thing. You seem like you wouldn't want to actually break down the bone, but it's actually part of very normal processes. In order to keep the bone tissue strong and healthy, you're going to have to break down some of the older tissue, and so that's what this will do. It also can have implications if osteoclastic activity is kind of bumped up, so that's the case of what's happening in terms of osteoporosis. You're going to break down bone without having newborn bone formed by the osteoblasts. So a few things I want you to note here. Osteoclasts are huge cells, so huge in comparison to the other cells that we just discussed. Also, right in this region right here, you have what's referred to as a ruffled border. So this is a very extremely infolded type of plasma membrane. And from here, you're going to have secretions of lysosomal enzymes, so very high in terms of its acid content, in order to actually break down the bone. Now, one thing I want to note is that the first three cells that we discussed, the osteogenic cells, the osteoblasts, and the osteocytes, are part of the life cycle of one type of cell. So an osteogenic cell will turn into an osteoblast. That osteoblast will secrete that extracellular matrix and keep surrounding itself until it doesn't secrete anymore. And once that occurs, then that's referred to as an osteocyte. So kind of the end of the life cycle in terms of this is the osteocyte, important in terms of that daily metabolism. Now, this osteoclast is its own thing. It's not part of this life cycle. It's actually going to form by the creation or the coagulation of 50 monocytes, or up to 50 monocytes. So it's a completely different life cycle, but also just as important in terms of actually breaking down the bone and allowing for healthy bone to stay. So we're going to, those are the four cells I want you to be familiar with. Now I want to talk about the two different types of bone, so the differences between compact and spongy bone.